talk about Lyric. Did we do Persepolis yet?
No.
Okay. So, we'll get into that later. So, Lamassu, this was made during the, I'm pretty sure it was the Abbasid Empire, the Abbasid Dynasty, and the Middle Eastern region during 705 BCE, and it's made out of alabaster. I'll give you guys the same big information.
So, alabaster is a place in One Piece where Crocodile is when Luffy defeated
Crocodile. Do a little bit of history. The Assyrians, not the Abbasids. So, history lesson. So, the Assyrians controlled Mesopotamia from around 1000 BCE to 500 BCE. And then, so, the Lamassu was made during the height of the Assyrian Empire, which was, I want to say, maybe around 600-700 BCE, when they had a very large power over the Middle Eastern part of the world, so Southeast Asia and Southwest Asia, Southeast Europe, and parts of Northern Africa. So Assyrian artists praised their painting and their work, and this possibly contributed to our Lamassu's face. So when we see our Lamassu in the next slide, we're going to see that it has a royal hat. It has a very, very long beard, which is very characteristic of ancient Near Eastern art. If you have a question on your test about ancient Near Eastern art, you have to identify which picture is which. Always look for the beard, the longer face, and the alabaster or the stone or the limestone. That's usually a telltale sign of not Middle Eastern, but Near Eastern art. Lamassu look like to you? Give me some descriptive words. What are you seeing? What does it remind you of? Anything you've seen before already? Fine.
I don't know how the word was, but it's like, you see it like in Greek mythology where it's like, it has like the body and the face of a human, well, like the face of a human, and then it's like a body of like a doctor or a horse.
Alright, what's that word, guys?
Centaur.
Oh, centaur. That's a different thing. Combination of human and animal characteristics to create one being. That's the only word I can use for it. So, we see our Lamassu has the head of a human and has the body of a horse, and it has the wings of, I believe it's an eagle, if I'm not mistaken. So, it has the body of a horse, wings of an eagle, and the head of the Assyrian king. So this anthropomorphic gate guardian is meant to protect the palace of Sargon II. So Sargon II was one of the most powerful rulers of the Abbasid Empire. I think he ruled for like 40 years. So you can see it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 legs. And when you see it stand, when you see it horizontally, when you're face to face with it, it's at attention and it's guarding whatever is behind it, but when you're standing right next to it, it's walking past you. So I like to think of it, so when you're leaving, when you leave the palace of Sargon II, he's, or they are walking with you, protecting you wherever you go. And before you get in, he's guarding the sacred treasures of Sargon II. So that's how I like to think of it, if that helps any of you. So you can see the lion's facial expressions are very neutral. So this is contributing to its harmony, stability, and balance that the artist tried to impose on the face and the body. So the Lamasu itself is meant to guard off spirits at either side of the gate of the Assyrian palace. So this is not, we don't just have one Lamasu, there are thousands of Lamasu, and this isn't just, can't think of the word, but they aren't just in the palace of Sargon II, they're all over the Near East in this time. So you go to a museum and more likely than not they're going to have one of these lamasu. There's one at the MFA and I'm pretty sure there's one at the Met. So we're going to see one of these in person, and they're like 8 feet tall and they're wonderful, they're majestic, they're just awesome to be around. They're pretty cool guys. And so purpose meant to ward off enemies, both visible and invisible. Now, Leah, did we talk about being in the round yet?
Go for it.
So being in the round. This chair, if this chair was a sculpture, it'd be in the round because you're able to walk around it from all sides, and it's carved from all sides, so it's meant to be seen from any angle, no matter what. And the lamasu, examples of the lamasu like this, are not in the round because they're not carved from all sides, and they're not meant to be seen from certain angles. Is that about right there?
Yes.
So think back to Androgyn number 3. I know I remember going back that night and seeing that I did not touch on being in the round, so we're doing that now. So what other things in our curriculum can you think of that are in the round? Think of Near Eastern. We just studied it. We just saw it actually. Have we even studied it yet? Have we even studied the votive, did we? The votives.
Ancient Mesopotamia is often credited as the cradle of civilization, that is, the place where farming and cities began, and it makes it seem so peaceful, but this was anything but the case. In fact, it was really a series of civilizations that conquered each other.
We're in a room in the Louvre filled with sculpture from the Assyrians, who controlled the ancient Near East from about 1000 BCE to around 500 BCE.